I do have another message. I've been planning on getting back to you. Haven't got there yet. I've been absolutely swamped this week, but I will do it. I will try and get to it today. BTC dominance is trying to stop Hunt, which I also thought was very interesting, and that definitely is a failure point, at least a potential failure point. We'll have a look at it all anyway, and see what we can come up with here. What are the possible traps that you need to be aware of? Well, the trap is that it can pump after the merge because people might see it as a success, and it may continue to pump. They might want to prove that it's a success, and it might want to continue to pump. So I just posted this thought here. This guy Rose posted this actually. I didn't see this myself on Twitter, but this guy is and you or used to be one of the largest traders on Bitfinex, and he used to be at the top of the leaderboard. So he does know what he's doing. He's a very successful trader, and he is worth paying attention to. So this would be a pitfall that after the merge, they could continue to pump ETH to show its success. So that is, in my view, one of the potential pitfalls, traps when you're thinking about shorting this. The best shorts will often happen on a new month, a new 6 month, a new maybe a new 2 week, or a new large time frame. So let's just look at some of these now. Now, the yearly candle, it's obviously shown a lot of strength, right? Can this drop down and flip red again? Of course, but as long as the yearly is starting to flip green, you definitely need to be, slightly careful. It's come a long way, but that has come a long way from a retrace. Like, this is a large green bullish candle engulfing all of these candles itself, and it's a breakout candle. So that's last year. So the dip back down can often be a buying opportunity to then send the prices higher. Okay, so overall, it is showing it's very, very strong. The thing is, it doesn't need to break out right now. It can, that's the worry. It can break out right now, but often in this pattern, like it could do something like this, for example. We could hover about here, and then next year, now it's a year away, we could drop back down to take liquidity here on a new year. So the possibility that ETH drops at some point is very likely. Is it gonna be next year that it drops down to take liquidity down here, or is it, is it gonna continue to, is it gonna drop from here? But if it drops from here, it's not taking liquidity. The liquidity needs to be taken on a new year potentially. So that's just something to keep in mind. This is, of course, an extremely strong candle, but I'm with you on it. This is a potential bearish stop hold. Like look at this. This is a potential bearish stop on situation. It's not. I don't even think it stop on it. Maybe it did. Yeah, it did stop on. Look at this. This did stop on right here, and you can see where price came back down to. Price eventually did come back down to maybe what's that? 38%, 40% of the retrace down the candle. So, if you look at that, a 40% retrace down the candle would be somewhere back to here, right? As a rough guide. So, well, maybe there a 38% retrace or something like that. So, between now and the next 6 month candle, you can see what happened there. But did it continue to pump first and then drop back down? But anyway, regardless, the stop point, the stop point here was a bearish stop point that dropped the price. So we are in the same situation right here. So it is looking into a very, 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 very good area for some sort of potential rejection. You can see here, after a large green candle, there was the pullback. Even here, a large green candle, I mean, it meant you had to catch the top, but you can see the pullback that did drop about 30% of the way down the candle. Okay, so this one, even this one, if you did manage to catch the top, there was a retrace back down. Obviously, if you had longer patience and held out in the drawdown, you could have eventually made money as well. So and obviously this big candle here we dropped, but is this the top? it's still green on the month. It's still showing strength. So there is an argument to be made that above this previous monthly highs, you know, this is still strong. But it requires attempting to catch a knife above that, or maybe not attempting to catch a knife, but trying to refine that down. So the way I would probably be looking at this would be a new 2-week candle. Look at that way it popped up there. That was just the way it was loading, I think. So the 2-week is very strong, extremely strong right now. What you would be looking for is on a new 2-week, for example, here, you can see what happened. You get a very strong close, and then there's one pierce above it that then drops the price. I suppose that, you know, even here, see the big breakout? The next candle, if you shorted this candle, yes, you were in a little bit of a drawdown, but after the big candle, price tried to top out and we got the drop. After this big candle, price tried to top out and we got a drop. These are 2-week candles, and they are decent sized drops. You can see, yes, this was a continuation breakout, and the price was strong, but you know, if you just watched the price and waited, I suppose you could say, you know, there was this bearish 2-week stop hunt right here. So if you waited, like, it was tricky because it was so strong and you tried to short into that, and you know you probably would have lost money obviously if you're shorting down here. But what I'm saying is, if you watch the candles and wait, it did give a bearish 2-week stop hunt. The slight worry that we have here, and I think it's probably going to go higher. Like, I think, again, like what I was talking about a minute ago, I think it may need to come above this candle, because this is a very strong candle with only 5 days left and the merge is very close. So I would suggest it's not quite topped out yet. But and also look at this is a bullish engulfing 2-week candle of this previous candle. See, of this red candle, it's engulfing that previous candle, kind of implying that there probably should be some more upside. So my alarm, we never came back. When we were down here, I set that alarm and we never actually came back down to stop on the level. So I'm going to move this alarm right now. And if we do stop on the highs of this, that is going to be very interesting. I would look to only trade or short a 2-week candle, because, you know, if it's flipping green again, you definitely need to be careful. There is worries here. This is a blueprint for success pattern, and these, I know it's a BTC pair. We've talked about this many times, and I've made charts about it a long time ago when we were creating even this small pattern. I talked about this pattern right here, and the whole structure, that it was a blueprint for success, and we are still in this bloody range. So the range has lasted way longer than anticipated, but there is an element that this is a bullish deviation here. And, you know, I don't really want to be crazy about it, but if you remember the fractal of zero, was it zero? That, you know, when you create this pattern, it really can go a lot higher. The problem is, this is a BTC pair. I actually had a quick scan there and I can't see if it was zero or not. Another thing I just want to point out here now is that it is a knife catch to be shorting here. But if you look at the past history, you know, most times coins will, you know, shorting into a green candle is dangerous. Shorting in a red 3-month candle, like this is a 3-month chart. When it flipped red, that was a clear time to short. When it flipped red, it was a clear time to short. When it flipped red, it was clear time to short. When it flipped red here, it was clear time to short. When it flipped red, it was clear time to short. So it you know, it's dangerous trying to knife catch it. The safe trade is to trade when it does flip red on a new 3-month, if it flips red. Shorting right here is a bit of a knife catch. What if we open up on a new 3-month and you know, we continue to explode and surprise most people, and Ethereum doesn't pull back at all? Because it is you know, it is a very strong pattern in a way. I mean, it's holding up better than most of the market at this point. It is shorting that relative strength coin, but it is, as you pointed out, it's into a 6-month bearish stop hunt area, very important area. So sorry for the long video. I would I would not be shorting just yet. I would wait until a new 2 week candle. Ideally, the best situation would be to get a bearish 2 week stop hunt. Like here, I would think something like that is the best case scenario to be shorting if you can get that on a new 2 week. Before a new 2 week, you are slightly pushing it, especially as we are coming into the merge. If I do flick through every time frame here very quickly, 6 month, 1 month, 2 week, weekly, 5 day, 4 day, 3 day, 2 day, 1 day, even the 12 hour, and even the 4 hour, I suppose, and even the 1 hour. Well, every single time frame is bullish, or at least every single time frame is green at the moment. Now, one last thing I want to say, I do think the new 2 week is very important, and coming into the merge is very important. Look at the bottom of the price. Look at the bottom. What happened at the very bottom of the price? There was an increase and a spike in volume, right? And ever since then, there's been no volume. I shouldn't say no volume, but you know, the volume has been allowed, the price has been allowed to grind up higher. We will likely need some sort of spike in volume here to signal a top, and that is likely to come around the merge, either into it or just after it. So you can see right here what happened at the very top of the market, right? Well, the very top of the market, well, that was the top of the market, but we have gone sideways the entire time, and you can see what the volume has done. The volume has went sideways. Then we got the spike in the market. Where was that? That was the very bottom of the market. We are likely going to need to see some sort of volume here at the top of the market to give some sort of clue that maybe these whales have had enough. That maybe they've rode that trend enough, and maybe they are going to start to sell out. I like your idea. I just think maybe it might need a little bit of patience. It's a difficult short when every single time frame is green. Green on the month here as well. But I think that at least, you know, the safest way would be to trade a new 2 week candle.